In the previous tutorial, we learned how to create a PLSQL strong ref cursor using table-based record data type variable. There we saw a demonstration where we used the strong ref cursor to handle the data from all the columns. Mind you, all the columns of the employees table. This raises our concern that what if we want the data from some specific column of the table? That's exactly what we will be addressing in today's tutorial. What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back once again with another PLSQL tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn how to create a PLSQL strong ref cursor with a user-defined record data type. This tutorial will need a good working knowledge of user-defined record data type, which you can get from the PLSQL tutorial 37, whose link is like always in the description of the video. So without wasting much of your time, let's start with the tutorial and do an example. Unlike the example which we did in the previous tutorial, this time we want our strong ref cursor to handle the data only from the salary column of the employees table. In order to achieve this, we can use our old and trusted method of user defined record data type. Let's see how. Here we have created a user-defined record data type with the name my_rec. This record data type has one field, which is emp_sal. Unfortunately, right now, I don't remember the data type and the data width of the salary column of the employees table, and I am too lazy to check it out. Thus, I defined this field as an anchor data type. That way, the field emp_sal will automatically get the data type and the data width of the base column, that is salary. Now that we have a user-defined record data type ready to use, let's create a PLSQL strong ref cursor using this. Here we have our strong ref cursor refcur. As you can see, this ref cursor is returning a result of my_rec data type, which is the record data type we just created. In the next line, we have our cursor variable cur_var. This variable will be used to refer to our strong ref cursor ahead in the code. Apart from the cursor variable, we also have an extra anchor data type variable. This variable will be used to hold the data returned by our strong ref cursor. As we know, our ref cursor is returning the salary from employees table. Thus, the data type of this variable must be compatible with the returning result to hold the data comfortably. You can make this variable with the same data type and the data width as of the salary column of the employees table if you have this information handy. If you don't, then you can use anchor data type to create them as we did here. Ah, so much use of anchor data type in this tutorial. I didn't know that before. Anyways, if you don't know about anchor data type, then you can refer to that PLSQL tutorial 4. But for now, we are done with the declaration section of this PLSQL block. Now let's move ahead and write the execution section. But before that, I'll ask you to subscribe the channel if you haven't already and like this video as it keeps me motivated for producing more such interesting videos. Let's see if we can reach 100 likes in a week this time. That being said, let's come back to our topic and complete the remaining code. Here we are writing the execution section of this PLSQL block. Let's do it. This execution section is pretty much the same as we saw in the previous tutorial. The only thing which is different here is the select statement for which we are opening our cursor. In the last tutorial, the cursor was holding data from all the columns of the employees table. Whereas today in this example, our cursor is opened for a select statement which is returning the data only from one column, which is salary of the employees table. Note here, this cursor is holding the data of a single column, which is salary. This will not be possible if our cursor returns a table-based record data type. In that case, we will have to get our cursor opened for the data from all the columns of the table for a specific employee as we did in the previous tutorial. But if that is not what you want, then you can design your ref cursor using a user-defined record data type like we have done here. In the first statement, we opened our cursor for the select statement which is returning the data from salary column for the employee whose employee ID is 100. In the second line, we fetched all the data into the variable AT_VAR which we declared earlier in our code. In the third line, we closed our cursor. Closing a cursor that you are done with is a good practice. In the fourth line, we have an output statement which is displaying back the data which was stored into the cursor and later fetched into the variable AT_VAR. Let's execute this code and see the result. Here is our desired result. So that is how we create a PLSQL strong ref cursor in Oracle database using user-defined record data type. For more in-depth knowledge, you can visit my blog on the same topic. That's it for this video. Do make sure to subscribe, as in the next video, we will be learning the concepts of weak ref cursors. Also, like and share this PLSQL tutorial on your social media with your friends and help them in learning. So that is the tutorial on PLSQL strong ref cursor. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from rebellionrider.com.